aquaculture becomes the most important sector in Kenya's economy, since it is the key driver to a food secure nation and general socio-economic development. I'd like to declare this Unga free feed plant officially open. And thank you very much. The launching of this facility here today at Unga is a major milestone and breakthrough.
We are very, very excited that the plant is up and running, because the big question from all farmers is, but where will we get feed from? So what FoodTechAfrica brings to us is high-class Dutch technology and skills to the local market, upping production, upping knowledge, upping even aspiration.
The current fish feed facility that we opened today is an excellent example of using innovative technology in order to push a sector forward. Equipment is Dutch, as you have seen, but ultimately the production will be in Kenya, the market will be in Kenya.
And what we liked about the program is that it was really focused on establishing something locally in Kenya, and not so much only about education or about consultancy, but to really build something like a fish feed factory, but also like a farm.
So on the one hand, we had the technical experts, the gentlemen from Ottervanger and Almex who designed and engineered this factory. And on the other hand, you have Skretting, premier nutritional company, able to come up with the formulations for the feed, the technical expertise, and the ability to train Unga staff. And then, of course, there's Unga with their willingness to really take a leap of faith and invest in this facility, which is really the first of its kind in East Africa.
It's the first aquaculture plant. Just the equipment layout, the spacing in between the equipment, how clean it is one of the nicest plants that I've had the pleasure of being part of to build.
We've never been in the fish feed business. We're the very best at what we do, but we've never done fish feed. So FoodTechAfrica gave us an opportunity to partner with people who are experts at what they do.
They said in order to develop a viable aquaculture sector in East Africa, it starts with high quality, locally manufactured fish feeds.
But making quality feed is only half of the story. And as critical is the level of technical support provided to fish farmers to enable them to get the best results out of their significant investment feed.
To look at people 2 kilometers away, 10 kilometers away, eat fish. So the only problem was access to fish, especially fresh fish.
We designed a land-based recirculating fish farming system. We don't rely on water bodies. So with minimal space, we can produce maximum fish right next to the market.
We can produce here the 50 to 100-fold of fish in the same area as a pond. We do that by recirculating the water and by adding oxygen in it.
What you do here is you use technology that is very sustainable, so you're not polluting the environment, and everything is controlled. So from hatchery, pre-grout, grow-out. The first tank, of course, was new for everyone. It was new to Africa and also new for us. So we did that once, and then all the other tanks, they built themselves.
Yeah, Victor is my guy. He knows fish, and he knows what the fish need. He has enabled me to learn the latest technology in aquaculture I've known. I'm now the assistant manager. Yeah.
I can say also I'm lucky to be here, because this is a farm where the knowledge, you cannot get it anywhere in Africa. In the hatchery, what we do, we receive eggs, more so tilapia eggs. We incubate the eggs, they hatch. When they reach 1 gram, I have 2 options. I can either bring them to the farm, and also I can sell them. So we do provide seeds, fish seeds, to other farmers, our local farmers here in Kenya.
You can't just walk in and start operating the system. It's something you need to be trained on. So it's a whole goodie bag of people who are contributing to what you're doing. The whole thing is coming together very nicely, because one hand is supporting the other hand.
The guy that I first employed 4 years ago, effectively. He's still here, and he's now, he's the guy I can trust. If you look underneath, you've got poverty alleviation. We employ 60 people from the local populace.
We see now this concept is working. No one was eating fish in Machakos, and now suddenly the fish is gone, everyone is eating it, and it's not even reaching Nairobi, so that's a really good sign.
For people really to believe and go and act, it's important that they see that it works. And I think that's what we want to do, and educate people, show it to the people, and then help them to build up their own farm.
And now it's our job to actually take it from here, our first success, and build it out over the region, because these are just the first steps of this program.
This will also grow the economy so that we can provide jobs to the growing Kenyan population, particularly the youth, and also to create wealth, give people money for their livelihoods.
So we would like to reserve the traditional aid programs for, let's say, the poorest countries. In the case of Kenya, being a lower middle-income country, working with private sector when it comes to income generation, job creation, it has proven to be so much more effective and sustainable.
So the next step for us is to refine our kit, the production technology, and to roll it out to investors who want to invest in this production technology and to sign them up so that we start the blue revolution. We have a vision of aqua farming being as popular as dairy farming.
In Kenya, there's an 800,000 ton deficit of fish. So you need big projects like this to try and fill in that gap. If you look at East Africa as a whole, or Sub-Saharan Africa, it's going to be the fastest growing population as well. So the demand for protein is only going to increase.